Good evening, and welcome back to another episode of the Seneca Scout. In today's show, we are going to cover some local news, fast food news, and some sports news to finish it off. I'm Caleb McGill.
And I'm Maddie Conrad. Recently, 36 Seneca Valley students in band went through an intense audition process to join Honors Band, which is a more prestigious band class. They were picked among other musicians from Beaver, Butler, Lawrence, and Mercer County to participate in PME's District 5 Honors Band. Let's check in with the Honors Band to see how the PMEA event went.
Just this past week, our school's band celebrated those who were chosen to be an Honors Band at Pennsylvania Music Educators Association. Let's check in with Quinn Gallagher, a senior trumpet player here at Seneca Valley, with what he had to say about what it takes to be an Honors Band.
Honors Band is a select group of students that we auditioned for back in November. I think this year there's about 35 trumpets with only 15 open spots. And all those trumpets, we've all prepared the same exact piece. And we're given select excerpts, like one or two from that three-page long piece. And you have to play those in front of judges, as well as during the grading portion. There's also a sight reading portion to see how quickly you can pick up a piece of music. And so you find out after, like right before you're leaving, they post all the lists of all the instruments and what chairs you got. And a chair is like a ranking of the section. And then so once you audition, you have about a month to work on this music. And we did this last week, but then you have a Thursday, Friday, and then on Saturday you have a concert. So on Thursday you have about 5.5-6 hours of playing where you're just working on this music. And then same with Friday. And then Saturday you have about 1.5 hours just to clean up anything that you need to clean up. And every Honors Band, we have you get a guest director. This year we got one from Akron University in Ohio.
Let's check in with our only senior French horn player, Cammon Meener, to see her experience with band.
You get in through an audition process, and you basically get together with like some of the best kids around like the districts. I auditioned back in November. We went to Slippery Rock to audition, and we had gotten our pieces at like the beginning of summer. So I was practicing that all summer. It was a really fun experience. It was nice to be with a lot of other great musicians to make music. It's nice because for the concert season regularly, you're playing this music for like half the year and then you're performing a concert. But this, you practice it for 2 days.
Another senior, tuba player Jalen Guillamy, trained to participate in our intense Honors Band program. Let's see how he prepared for his role.
Honors Band is basically like an audition group up at Slippery Rock where you had audition in November to get in, and it was just like a bunch of schools around Butler, Lawrence, and another county, I believe. I take an IM class, so every day I would practice the Honors Band music, and when I got there, everyone was just trying to mentally prepare themselves, and we all trying to physically prepare ourselves by playing some warm-up tunes or just playing the piece again, over and over again.
We went up, we practiced a little bit more, and then we had a banquet, which is nice, and then we had the concert.
My experience with Honors Band, I enjoyed it, had a lot of fun, and I was able to hang out with some friends, and I also played a lot of pretty difficult and fun music.
It was a fun experience overall, because you just get to hang out and play music with your friends all day.
Congratulations to our SV's Honors Band and all their accomplishments. I'm Ileana James with the Seneca Scout.
And now, some sweet treats for the holiday season. Starbucks is giving out free hot chocolate if you buy a qualifying drink on December weekends. Starbucks announced this week on their Instagram to keep the spirit of giving for Christmas. The company is calling it, quote, hot chocolate cheer weekends, end quote. The offer only stands with one hot chocolate per order. Some of the common drinks people are pairing with the hot chocolate are the gingerbread oak milk chai in four festive cold foam drinks, peppermint chocolate, caramel brulee, sugar cookie, and chestnut praline. People got qualifying for the free hot chocolate if they buy a handcrafted drink that is grande or larger. Customers can also get this freebie from orders placed in-store or through the drive-thru every Saturday and Sunday through December 31st.
McDonald's is opening a new chained restaurant called Cosmic's that will be focusing on coffees and other drinks and having some of the same food items from the original location. This restaurant is viewed as a challenge to Starbucks and Dunkin' Donuts as the fast food giant seeks to boost afternoon sales. The Cosmic company opened their first location in Illinois almost a week ago, and they plan to open more locations in 2024. The new chain will allow the company to create customized beverages that are difficult for McDonald's restaurants to create, stated by the CEO of McDonald's, Chris Kempczinski. Cosmic's concept is, quote, what would happen if a McDonald's character from the 1980s that was part alien, part surfer, part robot opened a restaurant in 2023, Kempczynski added.
Now for the last fast food story. The Chick-fil-A restaurant in Cranberry is finally open for customers once again to see what recent renovations have been brought and how efficient this new system is. Let's check in with Maddie for more information.
On December 1st, the Cranberry Chick-fil-A has announced its reopening while being closed for a month. The purpose for this was to have more room for the drive-thru to make it go quicker and more efficient. The inside also was remodeled. We check in with manager Tanya Dudak for more information about this process.
How is the new setup in the drive-thru more efficient than it was before?
So our new drive-thru can hold up to 50 cars, so it's more efficient with the flow of traffic.
The first day opening up, were the employees excited to open back up?
Yes, they were very excited to be back.
How busy was it the first day?
It was very busy. We almost hit a record for sales.
The employees were very excited to get back. We talked to some of them as they expressed details that they love most about the job.
My favorite thing about my job is probably just working with the nice coworkers and getting to culture.
Hi, I'm Noreen, and I'm the hospitality director at the Cranberry and Wexford Chick-fil-A restaurants. And my favorite thing about my job is the people. I love connecting with our team members, and I love connecting with our guests.
Thank you, Maddie. Just 5 weeks removed from the Iowa caucuses, polls still have former Trump atop other Republican candidates. Those four remaining candidates being, besides Trump, being Ron DeSantis, Nikki Haley, Vivek Ramaswamy, and Chris Christie. They all battled in the final debate before the Iowa caucuses taking place on January 15th. They covered issues such as foreign intervention, immigration, states' rights, and economics, among other things. Despite appearing in none of the debates, Trump, who is facing prosecution for dozens of federal charges, still holds a commanding lead in the polls. The most recent poll performed by the projected Iowa caucus results conducted by Seltzer and Company showed Trump with earning 51% of the vote, a far cry from the second place, DeSantis, at a mere 19%. Nikki Haley was shown to be close behind DeSantis in third place at 16%, and Ramaswamy and Christie at 5 and 4% respectively. Unless he is physically unable to continue the pursuit of the nomination, it is almost certain that Trump is the most likely candidate to receive. Despite this, Chris Christie remains the only candidate out of the remaining four to take an anti-Trump stance thus far. The other three remaining candidates remain timid in denouncing him. It is inevitable the split in the party between pro-Trump and anti-Trump supporters, and it is widely believed this could give the opportunity for an unlikely candidate to snag the nomination. Just 5 weeks out, the results remain to be determined.
On Sunday, Bronny James, LeBron James' oldest son, made his collegiate basketball debut. The 18-year-old prodigy underwent a procedure to treat a heart defect this past July, sidelining him from all basketball activities. The University of Southern California Bronny School miraculously lost to the Long Beach 49ers, thought it was a win for Bronny James since he finally saw the floor after missing the first eight games of the season. He scored 4 points, gathered 3 rebounds, and dished out 2 assists on 33.3%, shooting a solid outing for the young guard. He showed his potential as a defender and as a three-point shooter, playing both sides of the ball well. After the game, Bronny said he was thankful for those who have supported him in his journey.
In more basketball news, although the women's college basketball season has just begun, the new mock draft for the 2024 WNBA season is speculating. Coming in hot is the number one pick is Caitlin Clark, the 6-point guard from Iowa, and she averages 27 points per game. Just this past week, Clark has scored her 3,000th point in her college basketball career. The Indiana Fever have won the number one pick for the 2024 season, making Indiana the perfect spot for the fifth-year player. The number two pick in the draft for the Los Angeles Sparks is Paige Berkers, a six-foot guard from UConn who has finally returned after an injury that impacted her first two seasons in a college career. She averages 19 points a game. The 6'4 forward from Stanford, Cameron Brinkett, comes as the third pick for the draft. She averages 30.9 rebounds per game. She would be a great attribute given the fact that the Mercury have had the least amount of rebounds per game out of every WNBA team last season. Let's get an opinion on the mock draft from some of the basketball players here at Seneca Valley.
I really like Caitlin Clark because she she really inspires me with her threes and shooting from like half court.
I really like Cameron Brink, and I think all of the blocks she gets in her post moves are very inspiring, and I hope she does well at Phoenix Mercury in the WNBA.
I'm excited to see what Caitlin Clark does at Indiana Fever.
And we finished with some local sports accomplishments. The University of Pitt women's volleyball are filled with hope and determination with the most recent win last Saturday against the Louisville Cardinals in the NCAA quarterfinals. They started off with a rough couple of matches, giving Louisville a lead of 2 wins in the best of 5. Then the Panthers reeled up 3 wins in a row to beat Louisville. With a record of 16-2 and this win under their belts, they got pushed to the semifinals with the hope that they could possibly win their first NCAA championship. The next match is currently taking place at the University of Nebraska at the time of the recording of this episode. Best of luck to the team.
And that's all we have for you today. We hope everyone has a great weekend. Thank you for tuning in, and we will have one final show for you next week before the new year.